This outdoor control board of the mini split inverter air conditioner starts the compressor and stops it after a few seconds. I have connected the indoor control with the outdoor control board. I have passed electricity through it to demonstrate to you the fault. The compressor has started to work, and you can see the UVW tester is working. This is compressor discharge, and this is the suction pipe. It is working, and the compressor has started to increase its RPM. It is working on the first speed. The speed will increase more. And it has further started to increase the speed. And suddenly, the compressor stopped working. The problem is that the compressor starts and suddenly stops after some time. The compressor started and stopped 6 times and now displays an HC error code, as this unit is from GRI air conditioning. This problem is caused due to the fault in the outdoor unit. Now I will try to rectify this problem, and the HC error means PFC protection in the outdoor control board. Now I will make you understand why this PCB board got faulty. The customer who gave us this PCB for repair told us that the electricity in his home had a surge of 300 volts, due to which the electronic machines installed in his home got faulty. The same this also has a problem, as I have shown you. He first gave this PCB to another tech for repair. The other tech turned it on, as the fuse has been changed. I think this capacitor might have been faulty, and it has also been replaced. Now I am seeing where the other tech worked on the PCB by finding the soldering traces. The IGBT has been soldered. The diode has been soldered. The reason for telling you the story was to make you understand how the other tech worked on this PCB. If the voltages in your home drop or increase, then this mini split will show the problem of HC. This problem could be temporary or permanent, as in this case. If the problem is temporary, turn off the electricity and turn it on after a few minutes. The problem will be fixed if it's temporary. Now I will tell you what PFC is. PFC stands for power factor correction. When the electricity is passed through the control board, the electricity could have spikes, or if I tell you in simple words, overvoltage of electricity. It could be in the form of voltage or current. For filtering these spikes, a circuit is installed in the PCB. After the fuse, a capacitor, a line filter, again a capacitor, then the reactor, I will show you this area by removing the heat sink. It has an IGBT and a diode. So all these components are installed in the PCB to make the spikes as less as possible to smooth the electricity. And also to make the compressor run smoothly. Now I will pass electricity through the PCB to test it. These LED lights have turned on, after I have passed electricity through them. The AC electricity in this PCB is fine, so I don't need to check it. I will check the DC link in the PCB board because if the DC link is faulty, the compressor will start for some time and then stop. So I am checking the DC voltages on the capacitors. We should get 300 plus volts on these capacitors on standby, as the compressor is not working. The maximum we should get is 320 volts. But now the multimeter is only showing 5 volts. Now I will wait for the compressor to start and then test the DC link. The compressor has started. The sound of the compressor is also not as polite as it should be. Now the capacitor has started to receive 290 DC volts. Let's keep testing it. And now suddenly the compressor has turned off. Let's see whether these voltages collapse now or not. Now I have removed the electricity from the PCB and discharged these capacitors. To prevent the multimeter from damaging and for my safety as well. Warning, never work on electric circuits if you are not trained or a professional. Now I have set the multimeter on continuity mode. So, first of all, I will check these capacitors. Continuity mode is the best to check capacitors inside the PCB board. Now here we got the beep sound. It should get charged. So it has been charged. These capacitors took the DC charge from the battery of the multimeter. As the DC capacitors block the DC charges when passed through them. And passes the AC electricity. As it had blocked the DC charges means, these capacitors are okay. Now let's check the bridge rectifier. I will set the multimeter on the diode mode to check it. The bridge rectifier is fine. Now let's check the diode. These points will show 0 as it is a dual diode. These points are also showing 0. This double diode is in the form of an IC. It is showing 0 on both sides, means it is not okay. Let's check the IGBT as well. I am also checking IGBT on the diode mode. So the IGBT is fine. Now let me make you understand the use of this diode in the PCB. And why it is causing problems when the compressor starts. 220 AC voltages flow through the center pin of the bridge rectifier. This is the positive side, and this is the negative side of the bridge rectifier. We get DC voltages from these pins. These positive and negative DC voltage traces from the bridge rectifier go toward this white wire, which is installed with the reactor. Then the orange wire comes back toward the PCB. I will make you understand on another PCB board. As when the reactor wire comes back into the PCB through the orange wire. A point is joined with this diode, and then the positive wire trace goes toward the collector of the IGBT. The negative trace is installed with the emitter of the IGBT. So when the IGBT will turns on, by supplying voltages on its base pin. It is an N-channel IGBT, so positive voltages will be supplied to its base pin. The emitter and collector will be joined together, through which resistance will be created inside the IGBT. Due to this resistance, the reactor will charge up. And current will be stored inside the reactor. Now the reactor wants to discharge this stored current. So it will discharge it toward the diode, and here comes the function of this diode. How? The current stored in the reactor is in the form of DC charges. But it discharges the current in the form of AC current. And this diode is installed here to convert the AC charges to DC charges to make these capacitor charges properly. So, in short, this diode is used to supply DC voltages to the capacitor to charge the capacitors. This diode has now been short-circuited. This is why these capacitors are not charging properly, due to which the DC link does not complete properly. And that is why PFC fault is shown in the form of an HC error. Now I have replaced the dual diode with a new one. Now let's check whether this PCB works properly or not. I have supplied electricity through the PCB. The compressor has started, and the UVW lights are also glowing. Now I am checking how long it works as before it stopped after 1 minute.
1 minute later.
Now it's more than 1 minute. The speed has decreased, and the compressor is running. As the PCB is not installed in the system, it will keep working by decreasing and increasing the compressor's speed. So, friends, we have successfully repaired this PCB control board. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch our next videos. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.